Tuesday night movie action. From the windswept cliffs of Ireland to the plains of the American Wild West, Tom Cruise and Nicole Kidman star in Far and Away, tomorrow, 9:30 on BBC One.
Welcome to Question of Sport, in which Ian Botham is the man in form. He's won the last two and leads Bill Bowen by 7-6. Ian lines up tonight with Herbie Hide and Jeremy Guscott. Herbie is the former British heavyweight champion, who's now the WBO heavyweight champion of the world. He's won all his 26 pro fights, 25 inside the distance. Jeremy is the Bath, England and Lions centre. He's helped the club win the league 4 times, the cup 5 times, and played for England in more than 30 internationals. Bill is joined tonight by Jason McAteer and Alison Nicholas. Jason is the Bolton and Republic international who played so well for Ireland in the World Cup finals. He helped Bolton win promotion to the First Division and plays for them in the League Cup semi-final next week. Alison Nicholas is the golfer who's won all over the world. 10 times a winner on the European circuit, she's been a successful member of the European Solheim Cup team 3 times.
Alan, which course do you play though when you play? Do you play the Duke? Or the...
Round one, the numbers game. Herbie, you're the starter.
Don't get a boxer.
I pick number one.
Oh, it's a South African runner.
See, the number one in Africa, it says so.
Oh, you had this all the week.
And you got it right then.
I got it right then.
Oh no.
Elana May. Yes, thank you very much. Yo. 2 points.
South African won Olympic silver and the world half marathon champion. Herbie, you've got a big fight coming up next month, defending your title. I mean, not ordinary opposition, Riddick Bowe. How much do you know about him?
He was the former world heavyweight champion. And on March 11, we will then know who's the best, who's the real champion.
Fancy him?
Yeah, of course, obviously. That's why I'm fighting him.
You tell him.
I'm a faster man, I'm a better thinker, I'm smaller, I'm fitter, I'm more hungry. He's got everything, but nothing that I can stop.
In other words, no problem?
No problem, that's right.
Hope it works out that way.
Yeah.
Right, Jason, number please.
Number 4, please.
The player in the foreground.
Mark Hughes.
You know the other one, by the way?
Is it Ian Crook?
No, it's John Polston of Norwich. Oh. Jeremy.
Number 12, please. Oh.
One to test.
I only know one.
No, I know that one.
Buddy Venison.
Jason writes it's Barry Venison.
When Barry Venison finds himself opposite you, you'll be in the air more than the ball.
Hello.
American.
Miss Alfredson.
Helen.
Helen Alfredson.
Yes. Solheim Cup player. Done well in American last year?
Yeah.
No.
Do you get a lot of bookings?
The only one I ever accept with you is here. Alison.
Lieselotte Neumann.
Lieselotte Neumann. Swedish golfer. Won 3 tournaments at last year's European Tour.
That's right, yeah. Did very well.
It's Ali's turn.
Number 3, please, David.
Somebody's just said in my headphone, Jimmy Nail.
Serrano.
Rupert Moon.
Clenethly in Wales?
Yep.
Scrum half?
Yep.
Well informed?
No, not informed at all.
Oh, she walked
as soon as it came up straight away.
6-2 to Bill. Ian.
Number 5, David, please. Nicholas. Nicholas Price.
Open and US PGA champion.
He's picking me up in 3 days' time.
Bill Stern.
Number 6, please, David.
Ta.
Giddy up, giddy up.
It's like Adrian Maguire.
Adrian Maguire. Second in the National Hunt and Jockeys Championship last season. Going well this season, and you're going well for 2 points. So end of the round, 8-4 to Bill.
Got an individual question now. No problem.
Round two, in which the guests get their own sports, the captains must tackle whatever comes along. Herbie Hide, you're the starter in each round. You'll recognise Bruno, of course. But who are the two Americans he puts on the canvas?
First one is Curtis Ruth Williams.
You're right.
And the second one is Jesse Ferguson.
2 out of 2. Herbie, I know you've got Mr. Bo to take care of yet.
Yeah.
But a lot of Britons would like to see you fight Bruno. What about that?
I would have liked to fight Bruno a few years ago. And he didn't want to fight because he was worried about me. But now I don't see why I should fight him. I'm a sportsman. I don't really want to fight for money. Frank, to me, all is interesting is the money. So I will only fight people who want to go out there to win. He just takes part, and I want to fight for the title. So I'm taking on Riddick Bowe because I know he wants to win.
And no chance of Bruno later?
No chance of Bruno there.
OK, on we go. Jason, happy memories for you from last season when Bolton reached the quarterfinals of the FA Cup. For your points in this sequence, who scores for Chelsea? Who's the keeper saving a penalty? Right, the scorer for Chelsea?
Gavin Peacock.
1 point. The goalkeeper who saved, the penalty?
Walker.
Of?
Spurs.
I think you're winding me up a bit. You knew that well enough, didn't you? Obviously a Liverpool boy. Now playing at Bolton. What happened to Liverpool and Everton then?
Just slipped through the net, I think. I don't know. I was playing for a Liverpool side, Marine, semi-professional. And we were playing against Bolton in a friendly. And I just done well, and they asked me down for the trial, and that's how it went from there.
Yeah. Now, you're a member of a very sporting family. Two uncles, British middleweight champions, I think.
That's right, yeah.
I knew the eldest one, Pat, very well here, boxing for the British and Commonwealth title, and making a very good job of it indeed. And he looks after you a bit, doesn't he, from a distance?
He's in America, yeah. I was actually sparring partner for that fight.
That was back in 56. When were you born?
I wish I was around to see a couple of his fights.
Now, this is Les in action. We've got Harry Carter commentating.
On everybody urging young McAteer on, but I think it's too late for him. Pritchett's lost quite a bit of blood from that cut round his eye, and it's looking bad again, but I think Pritchett has won it. There it is, and Pritchett is the winner. He's kept his titles, the British and Empire middleweight titles, and he's kept his unbeaten record. And McAteer, this 23-year-old boy from Birkenhead, bitterly disappointed.
Were you ever tempted to follow the family tradition?
Not really. My mum wouldn't let me box. She thought it was like, you had to be a bit mad. Sorry.
Were you right there?
Sorry. It's mere like that, yeah. Not like that.
Okay, well done, Jason. Thanks very much indeed. Jeremy, for you, back to 1992, the year England won the Grand Slam. For 2 points, name the Scottish and Australian try scorers at Lansdowne Road.
Cricket!
The Scottish player was a lad who's just joined us at Bath, actually, Andy Nicol. The Australian player is Tim Horan.
And you've got two out of two. Alison, Woburn last summer and the British Open for you. For a point, who do we see playing a bunker shot? For a second point, who nearly holds a long eagle putt?
Laura Fairclough.
1 point.
And Corinne Dibner.
The Australian plays a lot on the European tour.
That's right.
Nearly hold that putt. There's a gasp around the audience when they saw big Laura hitting that tee shot. She really does wallop the ball, doesn't she?
Oh, rips it, yeah. I mean, it's tremendous to play foursomes with her because I'm about 50 yards further down the fairway than I normally would be, so unless it's right or left sometimes. But, yeah, she's good fun to play with, and I've had to play some interesting shots, but enjoyed it.
Yeah. And you've got a good record with the Perry.
Yes, very good.
Good, keep it going, eh? And we go to Ian.
What have we got, David?
Well, all you have to do, Ian, is name the city where all this action took place. And for your second point, who do we see teeing off?
Ian Baker Finch, teeing off.
One.
Edinburgh.
You've missed out. So it goes across for a bonus chance.
Glasgow.
Gets you the bonus.
We were just saying that the rugby threw us, because rugby's not played really in Glasgow, and I thought it was Edinburgh. Was that the boat in the harbour, the Tuxedo Princess? I've fallen off there a few times.
I thought it was. What's that boat in Newcastle that I've fallen off with you?
The original boat that we fell off in Newcastle is now in Glasgow.
I thought it was bigger one in Newcastle, wouldn't it?
No.
Bill, you two must name the city, and for your second point, the international athlete we see leading in the women's race across country.
One or the other, isn't it?
Your choice.
Well, was it Charlie Nash fighting? Belfast.
Yes. Now, the leader in the women's cross country.
Not a clue.
Good athlete.
Very good to be leading.
Mm. Won it too.
Did she? Liz McCogan.
No, no.
It's not Christensen, is it?
It's the best young talent in Britain. Paula Radcliffe, the former world junior cross country champion. And that means, at the end of the round, Bill 14, Ian 9. Round 3, and the mystery men and women who try to mislead the two teams. For Ian's team, who's this back in the woodwork room?
Thank you. Robbie Fowler.
Liverpool and England B striker. You were waiting for that, weren't you, Jess?
He told me the other night he was on it.
He said Robbie Fowler's on it. I said, so do nothing. Must be obvious if he could have got it.
I didn't get it. Jeremy got it.
OK, Bill, Jason, Alison, who's the child finder?
Doesn't look as though it's Herbie's weight to fight.
Wouldn't be Lennox and Lewis. Didn't look big enough for him, did it?
So I go for that one. Duke McKenzie.
Who held three world titles at different weights. With daughter Jessica, got another daughter Holly. So end of the round, still 5 points the difference. Bill 16, Ian 11. Well, all they have to do in round four is decide whether to play at home for 1 point or go away for two. Herbie, you've got the first choice. Which American defeated Ken Norton in 1978 to win a world heavyweight title?
Larry Holmes.
Spot on. Jason, home or away?
Home, please.
Which Premiership player scored for the Republic of Ireland in the final stages of both the 1988 European Championship and last summer's World Cup finals?
Ray Houghton.
You've got it right. If you get through the semi-finals of the League Cup with Bolton, Wembley.
Yeah.
Have you been there before?
Just to watch Liverpool beat Everton in the FA Cup. Yeah. I was sitting by the Queen, actually, just a couple of rows by her, like. My dad got some boss tickets, so...
You're sitting near the Queen?
Yeah.
Best seat in the house?
Yeah, and Rushy got it, come on and scored too. And we won.
Made your day?
It was brilliant, yeah. Made the trip home nicer.
Now, of course, you could play Liverpool in the final.
I know, yeah, I'd be gutted.
Yeah, but once you're there, there's only one side for you, and it's called Bolton Wanderers.
That's it, yeah. Once we're there, it doesn't matter who the other team is, like...
Hope you enjoy it.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Jerry, home or away?
Home, please.
Stay home. We'll take a gamble.
Name Ireland's most capped centre, who won his 46th cap earlier this season after a two-year absence from international rugby.
Brendan Mullen.
Brendan Mullen is right. Ali, home or away?
Home, please.
Who won Wales's first ever European Tour title at last year's European Masters?
Helen Wadsworth.
That is good. Right, Ian. 6 points behind. Home or away?
Away.
Listen, which lads. World Championship event had 453 male entries and just one female entry this year?
What's been going on while I've been in Panto Land? We've just got fairies and ugly sisters and things. And nothing.
We know which one you won.
Yeah. And there's nothing wrong with the ugly sisters, I'll tell you.
What has it been, World Championship?
Darts.
Good call.
But wrong.
Afraid so.
That was a very good call, that beef. You've impressed me there.
So can we get on with it?
Yachting.
The World Championship, which had, it has started, 453 male entries and just one female entry this year. The World Snooker Championships.
Well,
one female entry, Alison Fisher, who lost in the fourth qualifying round. Jerry, I've got to say, it's nice to see you back on not just the international scene, but the club scene as well, playing rugby, after two desperate seasons. Now, that injury you had...
No problems whatsoever. It's good to be back playing for Bath and England, and looking forward to playing many more games.
And no restrictions at all in training or playing or anything?
No, I just I have treatment, physiotherapy twice a week, and that's just stretching and loosening off the muscles in that area.
He still thinks he's in Panto. Yeah. I ought to explain that Jerry had a groin injury. Which Ian is thoroughly enjoying.
I'm loving every minute of it, yeah.
Anyway, I'm glad all's well. It's great to see you back.
Change the subject very quickly and move on with the show.
OK, Bill, home or away?
Home, please, David.
Which member of Scotland's 1987 World Cup squad made his first ever international appearance last year.
We've had so many, haven't they, played? Was it the second row? Against South Africa, Richardson. Jeremy Richardson.
Spot on. So Bill leads 19-13. What happened next is a question in round five, and for Ian and Co, it is golf. Amy Alcott holds the winning putt in the 1988 Dinosaur Classic. What happens next?
Yes. There's a lake, and the caddy, and she goes into the lake. She wins the tournament, and the caddy either throws her in, or they both go in the lake, or she ends up in the water, and she dives in or jumps in, she's won the tournament, and I'll have 2 points.
That's the winning putt. A quick hug, and then the celebration.
Do you hear the great story about Simon Hobday? No, South Africa. He's got 3 shots with a 2-iron in the hole to win the tournament. So he's topped it, and it's bounced, and it's hit the lake in front of the green, and Dan busted across and ended up that far from the pin. So Hobbs has walked up. He thought, if it's good enough for the ball, he just walked straight in the lake and disappeared under the bottom. bubbles a lot, and just came back out with a putter and tapped it in. That's pretty true. No one's got that on.
Nice one. OK, Bill, Jason, Alison, a middleweight contest featuring the former world champion, Alan Minter. The referee stops the fight in the middle of round four. What happens next?
Referee has a call of nature. Well, he either stops it for a call of nature, or he goes to have a word with somebody in the crowd for coaching or encouraging one of the boxers, which you're not allowed to do.
Which one do you want?
For coaching.
Won't do.
Well, it's got to be something along the coaching things, because he's saying it's not enough.
Better story, we'll go for the dodgy Vindaloo.
Alan Minter had won the Olympic bronze in 1972, as an amateur, turned pro then. Harry Gibbs on the way.
Gentlemen, please, in 1 minute 20 seconds of the fourth round, the referee has disqualified both boxers for not giving off their best.
Oh, I remember that, didn't you?
And there are now 4 points between them, 19-15.
Dodgy's going to lose a much better one.
The 1 minute round now, which gives the teams the chance of 9 points in 60 seconds. Ian, Herbie, Jeremy, all well?
Yeah.
Boxing. The Commonwealth and European heavyweight champion is?
That's Henry Raikkonen.
Rugby Union. Which club plays their home games at Franklin Gardens?
Northampton.
Where's this?
Sunderland, Bolton, Manchester, Liverpool.
Nottingham, Bristol City.
Nottingham, Bristol City, Liverpool.
Swindon.
Swindon.
Right.
Boxing. At which weight did Neville Brown win a Lonsdale belt in 94? The weight.
Neville Brown?
Yeah.
A light middleweight.
Heavyweight, middleweight, light.
Middleweight. Yeah. Rugby Union. Who's the only player to score over 800 international points?
Hastings.
Fox. Liner.
Liner. Three to name. That's all you've got left. Less than 20 seconds.
Mike Rea.
Naz. Yep.
Who's?
Prince Naheem.
Yep. Nazim.
Sharp.
Lee Sharp.
You've got it with 12 seconds to spare.
Well done, team.
Right, Bill, Jason, Alison, all OK?
Yep.
Soccer. Which club reached the First Division playoffs in 93 and 94 without winning promotion?
Portsmouth.
Leicester. Carry on.
Golf. The last
Derby. Derby. Carry on.
Golf. The last woman to win a second US Open was?
Carry on.
Carry on.
Where is this?
Patty Sheehan.
Yep.
Monza. Carry on.
Silverstone.
Belgium.
Yes. Soccer. Who scored 2 goals in last season's Coca-Cola Cup final?
Saunders.
Aston Villa.
Saunders, yes. Golf. On which British course will the next Solheim Cup be held?
Carry on.
Carry on.
Three to name. 10 seconds.
Wembley.
Gaza.
Gaza, yeah.
Paul Way.
Yeah.
Ambrose.
Right. Where will the Solheim Cup be held?
Lindrick.
No,
you're out. Chepstow, Saint-Pierre. In 1996. Stocker, which club reached the First Division playoffs in 93 and 94 without winning promotion? Tranmere Rovers. So it's closer now, 26-24.
There he is, he's still in the lead. Still there.
Well, back we go to the numbers game. Six left. Herbie, you lead the way.
Number nine. Sabatini.
Gabriella, the Argentinian. The scores are level now. Jason.
Number eight, please.
Yes.
Ooh, looks like a boxer. Yes. Ooh, looks like a boxer.
No, that's the thing. Lewis or Holyfield?
I go Holyfield.
All right, you go for it.
Evander Holyfield.
Get this right, you can take the lead.
We don't know what it is.
It's not heavyweight. Is it a heavyweight?
I can't help you.
Nah. It could be Lewis.
Let's go with that.
I think, yeah.
Who's we'll go Lewis? With Lewis.
Lennox Lewis?
Yeah.
It is. Oliver McCall. WBC heavyweight champion.
It doesn't have Oliver McCall at all.
Scores level, four left. Oh. Jerry.
10, please.
Very good player. This would be Lanzarotti, wouldn't it?
Might be Martin Johnson. I'll go for Jono then. Oh, it's mine, isn't it?
It's yours, not mine.
Martin Johnson?
No.
No.
It's darker than that. Martin Bayfield.
Simon Shaw, Bristol second row towards South Africa with England last summer. So, three left, 26 each. Mm. Alison.
Alison, could you find golfer?
Just whatever you do, ignore him. He's easily forgettable.
You can do it for me.
Number seven, thanks, David.
Lady golfer?
Oh, like this one. We're just thinking, what? Norwich supporter here. Nothing
to cook. Is it?
Yeah, go on.
Oh, you want me to say that?
Efan Ekuku.
In Norwich colours, now plays with Wimbledon, Nigerian international.
I knew that.
Bill 28, Ian 26.
Tell you what, Beef, I'll go for my batting number, and you go for yours.
Two. Is that Pontius Pilate on the left and Graham Gooch on the right?
You've got 1 point with Graham Gooch.
Pontius Pilate Illingworth.
Raymond Illingworth. Well, this could be the match winner.
Oh. Another boxer.
You didn't know about us, did you?
How many boxers are there been in this picture board?
Two. Nobody got the other one.
And somebody's going to get this one, but I don't think it's going to be our team.
Well, that breaks my heart.
Mm. We don't know it.
In fact, I wouldn't have got it if I didn't have Herbie sat here.
Mm. Herbie's had a good one, I hope he goes as well
against
Mo.
No, we're saying nothing. We're saying nothing. We're not going to mention them. No.
It's not Evander Holyfield, anyway.
No. Nope.
Pyatt. Pyatt. It's not Martin Johnson, Chris Pyatt.
Yeah, it's definitely not Martin Johnson, Bill.
Chris Pyatt.
Who put that up?
Jason did.
He's won you the match. So the captain's now level at seven rounds each. See you next week, same time, same place. Till then, goodbye.
All roads lead to Sonia's country cottage. Ain't misbehaving next
time. Paul resuming his career after a long